Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome back to the workshop. It's been a while since we've done a full build. I've been traveling. I've been doing other stuff. We had the visit to Round 2 Models. We had the new kits video, and now a kit they handed me in person in Indiana, the Boss Nova. They handed me this and a couple other kits right when I was in their office and said, take them home with you. It'll save us on the shipping. So we're going to be building this little beauty up. Check out that Chevy Nova wagon. It's a mid-engine dragster. It's a full-on custom. There is absolutely no way to build a stock Nova wagon from what's in this box. So we will take a look and see what we've got going on. First, we will take a look at the sweet retro box art. Look at that thing. It's got the chassis, wheelie bars, the front axle, the basic steering on it, and then the monster Hemi engine. We can see the spark plug holes through the top. Check it out. The GMC 671 Huffer or blower that they would call it on there. She is a sweet little machine in 1/25th scale as always. You have one of four options to build the engine. You can do the 8 manifold, the fuel injection, the 8-carb with the supercharger, and the standard supercharger off the top there with the big zoomies hanging out the side. Got the blower motor. You can wire yours up if you want, but it does not have that. And then it's got this giant supercharger duct on the top that will reach to the roof. Otherwise, you can just let it pull air from the cabin with one of the other three engine options. We've got parachutes on it. We've got toolbox, helmets. We got all kinds of stuff in the box of the Boss Nova. First up will be our single piece hood. And of course, it's got the insulation and everything, but there's nothing under the hood of this car at all. It all sits in the middle. We've got the Nova body here. You can see the giant cutout for that blower. We can also put a scoop on here if you choose to go that direction. It's got underhood detail. I mean, it's got the battery, the radiator, and everything. But obviously, when I build mine, I'm just going to be gluing the hood in place so I can paint it all together because we're doing the dragster option. You can see the rear wheel wells are cut out. So if you wanted to make this into some sort of stock vehicle, you're going to have a lot of work to do. Got our front end there. We can see where it will mount to the chassis, or it did back when it was a promo. And then we've got our interior, which will be very, very sparse. We can see our headers here, or our zoomies, preferring which way you call them. Our leaf springs on there, roll cage parts. We've got our engine mount in the back. We've got our driver's seat with belt molded in. Got our dashboard. You can call it that, pretty much just part of the roll cage with some gauges mounted on the bottom. Got our parachute there. We've got an extra, looks like a carpeted section here. I wonder if that's maybe firewall for in front of the engine. Keep it from blowing up, and then we'll have part of our roll cage there on it. I'm just guessing. We've got a hinge. We've got our steering column. So it should be a very simplified build. We've got what looks like a body pan for the spoiler in the front. Got our differential or spool for the back end. We've got that face mask, which is, it's very creepy looking. Is that our drive shaft, maybe? Possibly. We've got our scoop for the roof. Inner wheels. Got our header plates for the cylinder heads and our header spacers for farther down. Those don't attach to the body, by the way. We've got some fuel tanks. They didn't even list those on the box. It could be water, fuel for both, where they mix it up. We've got our pulley and drive system. We've got our intake, oil pan, top of the toolbox there. Chassis, molded in white plastic, mounts for our springs. You can see this is definitely for drag racing only. Mount for the steering column, floor pan. It's a completely customized vehicle. So the good parts about that is you can go ahead, paint things any color you want, and nobody could say you're wrong. We've got two axles, one a little bit thicker. So I'm guessing this is for the rear. This is for the front to hold everything together. Two sets of glass on this model. We've got a beautiful clear section, and we've got the red. Now, you could do this in any combo you wanted. Obviously, you can snip this stuff off, put clear in the back, red in the front, or vice versa, whatever you wanted to do. I like that it's got these little rivets molded in there. You could highlight those with a pen. See those rivets on there? Get it in that ring light so it reflects better. Nice clear glass, no issues with that. Easy to work with, easy to put in place. We got a sweet looking decal sheet on this one. Lets you replicate the box art very nicely. Don't have to paint those black stripes in at all. Got all of our sponsor decals, got the Hemi logos and multicolored Boss Nova emblems. Gold and black and red with white trim around them. Can't really be seen on camera. The Nova 2 and some AMT logos for us to help out. We've got a nice chrome tree, got our axle supports, front springs, got our cylinder heads, intake parts. Depending on which one you use, there's our tape. I've still never seen a reel-to-reel tape player in a car before. Got our front wheels, deep dish rear wheels. Looks like our onboard fuel tanks are these chrome things, could be. Got our hot shoe, always like that. That's always cool looking. And then we go to the second chrome tree. We've got our stock grill with our headlights chromed out. They should be chromed out. They want a glass on there. Got our exhausts if you want to use these instead of the ones, but I think these would come out inside the vehicle. Got our cross intakes on there. Got our blower parts. Looks like we got our firepower valve covers there. Just let you look slow. Got an oil pan. Got our engine halves, blower scoop, tail lights, rear bumper for the 63 on there. And then all the carburetors you could want, all bolted up. Wrapping up, what's in the box is one set of tires. Got the huge Goodyear slicks, which sand beautifully. They're two-piece, but they push together so nicely. You never need glue on these, and it just looks like a tire molding seam. So I never worry about that at all. Those look great. And the front tires are skinny bias plies with a thicker back on them. Mount into those wheels. You can sand those down. Those will look great as well. That's all the stuff that's in the box. That's quite a bit for a very simplified build. So I'm going to start gluing mine together, and I'll be back in just a moment. It has certainly not been a complicated build at all. There is a good amount of stuff in chrome. The entire engine and stuff like that is in chrome, which I will be painting over. We've got that all assembled here with its cylinder heads, the intake, the front timing cover, oil pan, and the clutch and all that are all in one piece. And then I did glue the magneto on the back as well, and I will hand paint that. Then I know it is securely attached. That will be set to go. We can just strip all the chrome off that as we need to. If you wanted to soak that in like simple green or super clean, that would strip the chrome off. You could paint over it. But even the great model builder, historian, collector Tim Boyd says he sprays over chrome all the time. So if he can do it, I can do it. We've got the blower assembled, and that looks nice in the chrome. So I didn't really get any issues with anything. Didn't get it all cloudy with super glue, so that I'm going to leave as is, as I also will in the blower housing. That's going to look nice just as it is. We'll paint it black on the inside so that it looks hollow, and then that will be set as well. We've got the giant riser on the engine. Now, it says that's to be used only if you don't go the supercharger route. Maybe it'll stick up too high with the hood scoop, but it's plastic. So if it's too high, I can just saw it off to the proper length because I want the scoop on it and I want the super goofy looking high-rise intake. So I will do both on mine, and then I can just cut it or sand it down to the proper height. It's not really hard to do. The headers are the most finicky part of the build. You saw how I dealt with that. I used a mixture of model glue and then super glue, used the spacer, and I'm not really worried about them being absolutely perfect because I have seen dragsters in person, so have you, and a lot of them are pretty banged up. I mean, those zoomies, all it has to do is direct the exhaust out of the cylinder head and out of the vehicle or off to the side. So they don't, you know, they weld them together, they paint them, and then they get all beat up as they move the cars in and out and work around them and unbolt them and drop them on the side of the shop and work on other stuff. We've got the toolbox and the fuel and water canisters, whatever you want them to be, all set up. And then there's our intake for the top of the blower, so we'll get that painted and on there. And then, of course, that is our blower belt and everything, which we will get painted up. On this one, we've got the hinge for the back of the body, which will be attached later. Our seat and our parachute on one tree. We've got that creepy mask, and that is the drive shaft and the front spoiler. You don't have to use the front spoiler, but if you decide to, paint it up and put it on the vehicle. The roll cage I assembled on the chassis itself. You saw me set it up there, get it aligned with the holes, and then we'll get everything set up as we glue it together, and the steering column will go inside there, lay through the hole there, lay on the little brace here. That will be installed when we get to that point. The chassis, I've got the leaf springs and the differential installed, or the spool. Got the front springs installed, and I was wrong. I thought the rear axle would be the thick one, but it's actually the front axle, and you will slide it through there, and it fits nicely. Then you will have the other components that we looked at during the assembly process, and these will actually slide in here, but I want to leave these chrome, so they will slide in on the inside and mount to the chassis. So since I can get those in and out of there, that's why I have that axle slid out once I glued on the front springs. I didn't want chrome front springs on my ride, so I left them off. But it is important to know that the skinny goes in the rear, and the instructions tell you that. And the thicker one goes in the front. Springs went on nicely all the way around. Here's the hinge for the body that will be going around that. And then when we get the body on, it will all close in like so. And then you see how that hinge hangs over the back. We'll glue that to the body, hide it underneath the bumper, and we'll be able to hinge that up and stand it up. Then I've got the back motor mount glued in place. And the chassis went together a lot easier than I thought. I know seeing a plate chassis, it was going to be easier than an actual, you know, a welded bar chassis and stuff like that. Those can be very, very finicky. Finally, the other thing that I glued together, of course, was the body. I glued my hood on because there's nothing under the hood, so I'm not going to detail anything whatsoever. We'll get it glued on, get it the same color. our hood scoop and our spoiler, and I pretty much want to duplicate the box art, which it was all the same color. Get our front bumper on and everything, and that glues on without issue. There's nothing to worry about on the interior. When we paint it up, the only trim we have to do is the side lights and the windshield and the back glass. If we want to do our drip rail in chrome, we can do that as well. It is prominent enough. Otherwise, you can go ahead and paint over it, whatever you want to do. We've got our lower body trim on the box art. It is chrome, and just to add a little bit with the yellow, I will probably do that in a metallic. We'll show how I do that by hand. So that is it. The car assembles quite easily. The Boss Nova is back, and I am going to get everything over into paint right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome back. Hope you're enjoying this first build we've done in a while. We've got the 63 Boss Nova center engine dragster here. So we're going to be taking a look at what we've built so far. We've got a lot of it together, pretty much most of it. What's left to do is attach the rear bumper, the hinge, the two fancy chrome wheelie bars, and the parachute, if you so choose. You can, of course, place the helmet and the mask inside and put the chin spoiler on the bumper when we're all done. So we've got that all assembled. I've got the body decaled and dried up here. And then I went ahead and brushed it with future floor polish like we've seen before. The decals go on perfectly. We got a nice grill here. I did the orange in the turn signals like the box art, and then left the sides the clear like the box art. Did the striping. The only thing I really changed from the box art was that I put the Hemi logo on the front fender instead of the crane cams on the box, and then put the crane cams logo towards the rear. Got our tail lights in and our trim. You could paint in the trim like a stock car, or I just did it in the silver with the tail lights and put the Boss Nova decal on the back. I used the red glass all the way around the back, put the AMT logo in that light there, and then did the regular sponsor logos on the side. The stripes go on well. The grill places in well. That's just friction fit in there. And then we did the clear glass because that's what I prefer. I know a lot of you will go with the red glass in the front. That's awesome. It looks great either way. I changed it a little bit from the box art. That was all, where they have the crane cams logo and nothing back here. I put the Hemi logo up front and have it all set up that way on my dragster. Then we've got the chassis itself. Got our nice large Goodyear tires. You see all those sand down. These won't fit on a socket to sand, so I did those quickly by hand, get the same representation, but those look awesome on there. We've got our blown Hemi in the back, and I did the riser and the block in the yellow like the car. You can choose how you want to do yours up. Got our belt there, just almost hits that firewall. And we've got our transmission hooked up with a little stubby drive shaft. Got our headers on, or zoomies, whatever you want to call them. And I like how they did the front suspension. It looks delicate, but it actually goes together nicely. And you saw how those slide in there. The steering arms just press fit onto that cross member. No glue needed. And then we have our other steering wheel and our interior, which just come down to meet those together. Got our little gauge package, our driver's seat, shifter, hot shoe, and everything. It really hasn't been too difficult. Glued the chrome tanks in the back. So we will get the body on, the hinge on. Don't need to do anything else but do that little bit of final assembly. I'll let you know how that goes when we return in just a moment. Well, everyone, we had a little bit of a hiatus there while I did some traveling and some other things, taking care of personal business, and now we're back on the bench. We're going to be getting two builds out per week, as long as I can maintain that rate. Well, we always have before, so we should get back in the swing. First one under my belt after the hiatus for a while is the 1963 Nova Wagon, the Boss Nova, the Chevy 2 with the Hemi underneath the hood, but it's not really underneath the hood. It's underneath the back doors. It's underneath the roof. We've got our hood scoop up here. We got a spoiler. The bumper just press fits in. The parachute glues on. The decals laid down beautifully. Final assembly is easy, but it is fiddly. You want to make sure everything lines up as best you can before you glue that hinge on. And the body just sort of rests on the front end. And it sort of rests on the roll cage. And what I did have to do with that raised scoop in the back, because I wanted that on there, I didn't want it sticking out, but I didn't want to use the fuel injector. You can see on this one, there is no engine back there. They went with one of the lower profile engines. I wanted that big goofy looking blower, and you can see it when you look through there, that it is on there. I had to remove about a quarter of an inch of the material from that riser to get the scoop to sit underneath the ram air on the top. And that's how I wanted my car to look, so you can build it up your way. Otherwise, you know, when you set it down there, you can move the body side to side. It's a very, very, very loose fit with just that hinge in the back. And in fact, you wouldn't even really need to install that hinge to display this model. The rear bumper will sort of hang on that hinge. You can put a post in the front to hold the nose up. You can display it that way. You can do whatever you want. It's not a traditional funny car where the hinge is, you know, really fully functional. It's just kind of sort of on there, and then you display it as you choose. There is no post or anything to hold the body up. You can use toothpicks. You can use a metal rod like this or anything you wanted, but it all lines up in the center. I made sure you see we got our steering wheel right in line with that center line on the hood, the blower back here. We've got our wheels in their arches. So take some time to adjust things and get it set up. This kit is very, very easy to build. I can't stress how easy it is to work on. Just because the parts count is low, it's not super highly detailed to drive you nuts. You can glue the hood on, you can build the engine any way you want, and that's what's a lot of fun about these fantasy vehicles or these build-ups like this, is that you don't have to worry about someone screaming at the camera, even though it's not authentic. You know, you just build it and have a good time. The decals lay down beautifully. I love the design on those. Of course, you have other options. Don't forget, you've got the gold Boss Nova option. So if you want to do a different color paint job, you can do that. But I liked the box art. They handed that to me when I was at round two for the tour video. If you haven't seen that tour video, go take a look. They've got so much cool stuff to see. And I hope to be able to make a trip back next year to get even more in depth on some things on that project. So anyways, welcome back to the workshop. We are back to building things on the bench. This weekend's going to be absolutely gorgeous, so I'm going to take the motorcycles out for a ride. And when I get back, I'm going to start on a new kit for next Wednesday. We'll have to see what I decide to build. Will it be something from AMT, Revell, Atlantis? I'm not sure, but I know I'm going to have a good time, and that's what you should do as well. Have fun with your models. Enjoy yourselves. Build them up like the box art. Build them up like your own fantasy vehicle. Take this body, stick it on something else. Use the chassis for something else instead. Do whatever you want. It's your hobby, and you should be enjoying it. I will see all of you at the next review.